So, that's a thing at least. There's supposed to be a bearer. Ah, there he is. And a lot of striped hyenas. And there's the ritualist Darfari, which is a tier 4 fighter as far as I can tell. Is that a boss hyena? It looks larger. No, it was just a normal one. Enough to put us over the carrying limit. So if we repair that, we don't yet regain our movements. Actually, I can repair that one because it's a normal. Of normal quality, so if we equip it, we get some of our carrying capacity back. Which allows us to move again. We can also repair that one. I guess we also have the knowledge of how to repair Darfari skin armors. But no, we don't have leather for that. This was the location where you got the Darfari weapons recipes earlier, but they were moved to the camp outside the sewers. So yeah, I usually drop down and try to survive the landing. I'm not sure if you can swim in that water. It might be a suicide to jump down and try to land deep enough to not take any falling damage. But this one works too. So yeah, we got the staff of the triumvirate from the remnant. But we got the feed from the book that we read. It wasn't Dredger, it was something similar. It wasn't the Reptile Letter Epic, it was... There are probably a few of those feed icons that we unlocked. It's not that one either. Why can I not find it? It was this one, probably. No, this is only the basic reptile armor. Well, I guess it's these three here. But yeah, the abysmal daggers and the abysmal sword that you craft consume that IV extracted from the corpse. But they are regarded as exceptional quality, so we get an achievement from them when we craft them. So let's just start heading back to the base. I might actually want to pay a short visit to the Imp Dungeon just to get some crystals, so that we have some crystals when we finally need them for Dragon Powder. Seven. And got another point of vitality. That's a really fortunate luck with the RNG. You're an armorer, but are you any good? You're not. We pick up those orbs, we are going to go past our carrying capacity again. But we do want those orbs. We can always give this guy something to carry. Get the human heart and then we'll look at the chest here. Let's take the stone. And the other guy is wandering away, it looks like. Is that a boss? It's a boss. Yeah, look at the size of that thing. So let's just discreetly try and go around. That should be the cave. And that's going to last us for a fair bit. Let's see if we can get some demon blood out of these guys. We probably won't. I think it's the exploding ones that are more likely to give any. We don't really need demon blood yet for anything. When we visit the archive, we'll unlock some tech that requires demon blood. I did pick up that war paint earlier, but I didn't equip it. That's probably in seconds of how long it lasts when you equip it, so that's 4 hours, is it? And we get a achievement for doing that. You don't need the flinted arrow. We'll give you iron stone instead. So now we have craft an exceptional item that we're about to do. Then we'll see about firing a trebuchet. But the next boss is at the Tower of Bats. Which I would be more confident in doing with an actual melee companion who can tank the boss. We were quite fortunate in finding that war paint from a chest, because crafting war paint yourself, even though we have the recipe for it, it's going to take brushes that to craft the brushes we are going to need fur for it, and fur you don't get from the starting area as far as I can say. As far as I know, you can get some from the jungle to the east, and you can get some from the colder areas to the north. Now I guess we pulled aggro from those hyenas. I guess we might as well start swimming. It should be overall faster than sprinting and waiting for stamina to regen and then sprinting again while avoiding possible aggro enemies. But yeah, we are now level 33 actually, not level 30, which we were when we started heading towards that boss fight. So that means we can unlock Master Mason and the Butcher for Steel Knife. We could start making honey as well, but I don't think we need honey for anything just yet. Guess we get steel weapons now. If we want to invest into them. We want to tame horses at some point, we might want to invest in that technology. Do we want steel two-handed sword? Possibly. It's not a horrible choice to pick. The Warhammer's not bad either. I don't think I want to go for the higher tier daggers, because we'll make the Abysmal Dagger when we get back to base. And because much of their damage early on is dependent on the bleed, it doesn't really increase their total DPS that much by getting higher base damage. I mean, every little bit helps, but in that regard I feel like the two-handed sword is sort of better candidate for improving on. And where did our follower sink to? He was underwater right there and then he vanished, so I'm guessing he's somewhere underwater here. But being overburdened doesn't really matter when you're swimming, so there's that. Also, I've yet to gain corona infection. It's the 14th or 15th of March now, 2020, when I'm recording this. No! Cool! You could see that there was a physical collision there, but it didn't do anything to us. So maybe their code fucked up. Would have been a need to get damaged by that one. Unfortunately, underwater combat is not enabled or even implemented in this game, as far as I know. We might be able to get another ghost chest from this location. Getting another 10 steel bars through that means would definitely be welcome. The thick leather will also... it actually might be enough now to make a heavy armor. Because we have the tier 2 armorer, that means we don't need to make as many... linings and paddings as before. And the Yamatai heavy armor is plus vitality, so it's a direct upgrade to our archer or the fighter if he's tamed. Because it naturally has higher armor class, so it reduces damage more. Because the AI helpers are not really capable of avoiding attacks or dodging. They're just sponges, basically. But I have a feeling that the chest hasn't respawned yet. It's going to be empty when we poke at it, maybe. Then again, we did enter an instance earlier, so that might have reset this part of the world in single player. Apparently so. Let's actually take all of this because we're already overburdened and the relic hunter shit is not that horrible. Actually has higher armor value. But yeah, now I'm increasing vitality to get at least impervious, which makes us more resistant to temperature effects, which might actually make us more likely to benefit from the soothing regen buff. But I do want to get the fierce vitality at some point. That's going to be really good when we actually do take environmental damage. Because this passive health regeneration persists regardless of any impairments, as far as I know. So if he suddenly starts bleeding, the bleeding won't hurt us as bad because we're regaining hit points from that region at the same time as we're losing hit points to the bleed. And eventually when we get far north and get to extreme cold temperature, we definitely need at least the impervious to survive there, but the passive health regen is also going to be very useful in withstanding environmental damage and chili debuffs. Plus the increase in our hit points, regardless of the perks unlocked, is also quite nice. So yeah, let's start smelting that one and unlock this one for wood and stone, which is going to be rather good note that we don't have to go harvest as much of those as we did before. And why are you swimming? Why are you swimming? Let me access your inventory. Bloody hell! Now he comes. We might want to get some bricks going as well. But we won't activate that. Well, we don't have that much fuel, might as well. And you are ready. That's nice. And we now have 67 thick leather here. Is that enough for all the heavy battings? 13, 13, 13, so that's 39. Then we have, this brings it up to 60 and up to 86, so we need 19 more to get a full set. Yeah, I don't think we have enough. I'm going to store some of these armor pieces here for later use, or just to free up some space. We do want to make the patch kit. Get this prepared. Oh, it's just glitching, it's apparently completely broken. Even though it shows that it's not. Maybe it ignores the decimals, like... It seems to do with stuff in this game. So, yeah. I need a new gloves and new boots. I do have those gloves around, but I think I need to make a new pair of boots. Or I don't, but I did regardless. I'm still overburdened, I guess it's the thrall. It's a fighter too, starts with steel mace. 765 base hit points. 0 vitality. Pretty average stats. Could maybe be worth it.